Hello everyone and welcome to a new IBMi RPGle sample video. I'm going to continue talking about how to run embedded SQL in our RPGle code. In this case, I'm going to show you how you can run SQL statements that you can create dynamically in your programs. To do this, I'm going to use prepare and execute. Let's go. Well, first of all, let's go to db24i and I'll show you the content of a table that I have created on my IBMi. I created this table last week, so if you want, you can watch the video too. Let's see its content. Let's go to db24i. Let me create a new SQL document and let me make this a little bigger. And let's select everything from numbers. Well, this is the content of the table. Okay, as you see, the table has 10 records inside with the numbers from 1 to 10. So simple. Well, okay, imagine that you have to make a program using RPGle and you want to use SQL to obtain the number of records of the table. For that, we don't need to create a dynamic statement, but as this is an example, let's do it. Let's go to code4i and let's create a new program. Well, let's change the filter. Let me make it a little. Let's change it. The new program is going to be test130. Let's create it. Okay. Well, let me write some code. Well, what I'm going to do is to create a statement that is going to be values select count from my table into this. Okay, well, as you see, I have written a question mark inside the statement. SQL will use it later as a parameter. Okay, prepare okay, this way we are preparing the statement, so SQL is converting it into a readable sentence using my statement. Okay, and execute using, and now I'm going to write here the parameters. As we only have one question mark, then I'm going to have one parameter that is going to be the variable where we are going to to put the result of these values. Okay, so for example, we can write here records. And after that, I will send the result records to my job log. Okay. Well, let me declare statement that is going to be, for example, this and records. Okay. I think it is all done. Well, let's now compile the program. Okay. And now let's try to run it, in this case, directly from within VS Code. Well, some people has asked me how it is possible to run the program from VS Code. Well, yes, you can. And also, if we write the result of the execution in the job log, we can read it from VS Code directly. Okay, what it is not possible, for example, is to run a program that displays our screen, okay? For that, you will need to go to the green screen. Well, let's go to my filter programs, change it, and let's write here the name of my program, save. And, well, let me make it a little. And you see the program is here, and we can run action, and we can run it, call program. And the result is this, 10. Okay? So, as you see, the program works perfectly. Well, it is very simple. Well, let's make it a little more complex. Let's now insert a record into my table using my program. Well, for that, I'm going to create a simple sub-procedure. Well, let me make it bigger. And let me write some code. Well, for example, insert record is going to be my sub-procedure. Well, we are going to have two parameters here, the ID. Let me see the structure of my table. We can go to db2 for I, go to schema, browser, tables, let's see numbers. Okay, and this is the structure. So we have a field with decimal 5 and a text of 10. Okay, so we can write here this. And this. Well, the two parameters are constant, but I can't use them directly with the execute SQL statement because the execution changes the content of the table. So for that, I have to declare two new variables inside the subprocedure, and I'm copying the content of the parameters into them. So we can do this. IDP, for example, that is going to be like ID, and text P like text, okay? And the first thing I'm going to do is this. So we can change the content of IDP and text P into my subprocedure. Well, let me now declare the statement. Okay, and the statement is going to be, let me go, insert into my table values okay, and these two question marks will be my parameters, okay, because I have to insert into my table two values that are the first and the second field of the table, okay? Well, now we have to do something like this, prepare from statement, okay? And execute, oops, using IDP and text P. Okay? Well, as you see, the procedure is so simple. Well, the only thing left to do is now is to call my sub procedure from the main procedure. So go, let's go here. Let's do it before the the execution of this statement, so we will see the number of records after we execute insert record. Okay, so for example, let's insert two new records. Okay, and 12. Well, remember that one of the best things that we get when using const in this in the parameters are the possibility of sending values directly. And not we don't need to declare variables that we are just we are going to use them just for calling as a procedure, okay? As they are as it is not needed, we can call them directly with values, okay? Well, let's now compile the program again, okay, and let's run it again. Let's go here again to code for I, and let's run it. Run action, call the program. Okay, and as you see, the result of the execution now is 12, because now I have two more records in the table, okay? Well, let's see them using db2 for I. Imagine that you don't have this open. Let's close it. Well, we can go to db2 for I. We can go and look for the table, and we can run it, run the select directly view content here, just clicking on it. Okay, and we get this. That is the content of the table. As you see, we have 12 records in the table. Well, as you have seen, it is very easy to create dynamic SQL statement just using prepare and execute, and with them we can also use parameters. I recommend that you check the documentation to see how we can use these parameters and when. Of course, there are things that cannot be done, and that is why it is important to see the documentation. Apart from having parameters, we can concatenate whatever we need to create a SQL statement, table names, libraries, or maybe we can concatenate different strings to have a more complex statement. With prepare and execute, there will be no problem to run them. I hope you liked the video and that it was useful to you. As always, remember to like and subscribe if you aren't already. See you on the next video. Thanks for watching.